Andrea, it's such a treat to meet you, and especially in this beautiful place.
Likewise, it's such a treat to meet you, and this place couldn't be more extraordinary.
Angel Fire, New Mexico, 8,000 feet and change above sea level, up in the mountains. We're in this grove of aspen trees. Now, it's only day two of the festival, so I know this is very new, but what does it mean for you to be composer in residence here?
Well, first of all, it's a huge honor to have been asked by Ida Kapavian to be the composer in residence. And they've commissioned a new work that was supported by the Bruce and Hilda Howden Composers Project, and that will be premiered next week. And they're performing another work of mine tonight and another work later next week, and I'll be talking a little bit about the creative process.
You live in Philadelphia. Your works are played in major concert halls in big metropolitan cities around the world. How is this experience different?
It's where I draw my inspiration as a composer. And I find that I keep coming back to northern New Mexico as a place that feeds me.
The outdoors, the dry air, the high alpine environments.
The mountains.
The mountains.
The light.
The light.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. The sky is changing all day long.
Yeah. Yeah.
The two pieces, the two newest pieces of yours that are being performed here this season are connected to work that you've been doing over about the past 10 years. And this is far too big a story to tell the whole thing. It's had profound personal and professional effects on your life and your work. But you've been working in the Himalayas. What kind of work have you been doing?
Well, I went up in 2008 to the Tibetan Plateau in northern Nepal to work on a commission with an artist, and then returned in 2010 with an anthropologist, an ethnomusicologist, to help the community document their folk music. There was only one singer who remained, and they were concerned that if he passed, that all the songs that told the history of the area would be lost.
The songs, the epic songs, telling the tales, the cultural memory of this
yes.
group, the language,
the language,
songs.
The Mustangi dialect of Tibetan.
So you were documenting this.
Mm-hmm.
So you made some recordings.
Mm-hmm.
You brought them home to the U.S. And then what happened?
Well, we sent them back to the area, Lomantang, Nepal, on cassette tapes with boom boxes and batteries and headsets so that the children could learn them and they could be in their library. And then they were accepted into the World Oral Literature Project at the University of Cambridge. That's essentially dedicated to documenting endangered languages before they're lost.
And we've been talking about some of those very same things with Robert Mirabal, another Music from Angel Fire artist this year, a Pueblo artist, Native American flutist, and he has some similar concerns. We were just talking about the changing sky. The wind is whipping up. I heard a little bit of thunder
yes.
a minute ago. The aspens are quaking all around us as we're talking. So maybe this place is telling us there's some importance to saving these languages, too. So that was an important part of your work. You not only sent those recordings back, you went back, right? And what happened then?
Well, I went back with Katey Blumenthal to continue the work that we did documenting the royal court singer, Tashi Tsering. And truly one of the most meaningful experiences of my life as a composer and as a person was what happened when Katey said, why don't you play some of the music that you had composed for Tashi Tsering, who hadn't heard Western music before. And I was a little nervous. What is he going to think of this modern music? And when he said, with the help of a translator, that this is the place where your world and my world meet, it just resonated so strongly with me, the power of music to connect us all globally.
And these were works that you had written drawing on the songs that you had heard a few years earlier on
yes.
the Tibetan Plateau. So
yes.
there was some inspiration there, as there is in two of the pieces that will be performed here this summer, Music from Angel Fire. One is a piece from a few years ago, and the translation of the title is At the Threshold of This Life. Do I have that right?
Yes.
And tell me about that piece.
The Tibetan is Tse Go, and what it essentially means is, at least in the piece, is that it's about these threshold moments that we embark on in our lives when we're just about to move into a new place, a new direction. What does it feel like to be in this threshold moment? So it's essentially about rites of passage. Mm. And the piece incorporates some of the melodies that we recorded with permission from the artists there who performed for us, and also utilizes some English poetry by anthropologist Sienna Craig, who accompanied me on my first trek. And the piece is really my personal response to what I experienced in Lomantang, Nepal. The extraordinary environment, being at the top of the world, the rich ancient heritage of the Tibetan Buddhist culture, and the sounds of the music, everything from clashing cymbals and long horns to what we were talking about earlier, the long, unbroken line of sound.
Mm, those long horns stand up and blow, and it goes all the way down to the ground, and a little bell at the end. And yeah. It's a kind of sound that shakes your physical core.
Yeah. You feel the vibrations.
Yeah. So some of that influence in that piece. And there's a world premiere. There's a brand new piece that you've written. Tell me about that.
Well, this is really exciting for me, and I was thinking about it this morning. Last night, Robert Mirabal was talking about the vulnerability of making music, of sharing music, and as a composer, the birthing of a new work, and sharing it, something I've been living with for quite some time. It's very exciting for me. So this piece, Earth Door, Sky Door, is named after the Tibetan Tse Go Namgo, which is akin to the Native American dream catcher, in that it lures in through its colorful woven cloths negative energies so that positive energies can pass through. So I decided to take the approach of something that fascinates me, the creative process, and the choices that we make as we are faced with different doors to go through. Which of those notes will make it through the door and become the seed or the DNA for the piece and become developed? And which ones maybe don't have quite enough potential?
And what happens to those notes you don't choose?
Right.
They're caught in that web. I'm fascinated by that idea, and I can't wait to hear how that plays out. The world premiere is going to be right here at the 2018 Music from Angel Fire Festival. There's so much more to talk about with your life and your work and the work that you've been doing in the Himalayas and how that's affected you personally and professionally. But it's just thrilling to at least start this conversation. I can't wait to hear your work and share it with listeners coast to coast on Performance Today. Andrea Clearfield, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. It's really been a delight, Fred.
Let's enjoy this thunderstorm that I think is just about to break out all around us.